صلِّ على محمد وآل محمد.
The ninth Imam from the Ahlul Bayt of the Prophet, peace be upon him, is Muhammad bin Ali alayhi salam. He is well known by the two titles, Al-Jawad, the generous one, and Al-Taqi, the pious one. Imam Muhammad al-Jawad alayhi salam was approximately 7 or 8 years old when his father was martyred. Yet he was the most learned individual of his time. Several people doubted that such a young boy could be the Imam, but they were spellbound when they tried asking the Imam for answers to their questions. The first meeting between the Imam and Ma'mun was in Baghdad, when one day Ma'mun was going out with his men in the streets. He then passed some children, among whom was Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam. When the children saw Ma'mun with his men, they ran away for fear of him except for Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam. When Ma'mun saw him, he stopped and asked why he had not run away. Imam al-Jawad replied so wisely, "The streets are wide, you can easily pass through, and I have no guilt to fear from you." Ma'mun was astonished at this answer and asked him, "What is your name?" The Imam said, "Muhammad, son of Ali al-Ridha alayhi salam." As Ma'mun rode off, he realized that Imam al-Jawad was as special as his father, Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam. So he decided he would marry his daughter to Imam al-Jawad. Ma'mun was now hoping that if they had a child, then he would also be his successor through the Imam. Ma'mun also wanted to do this because everyone knew that he had poisoned Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam, and he still wanted to convince the public that he loved the Imam. So by marrying his daughter to Imam al-Ridha's son, he hoped people would believe his lies. But the Banu Abbas were against this idea. To show how special Imam al-Jawad was, Ma'mun arranged a debate between the young Imam and the most learned man in the court of Banu Abbas. When the day of the trial came, all the scholars and the people of all classes attended the meeting. The hall of the meeting was full of people. Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam was only 9 years and some months at that time. The scholar debating the Imam asked the question, "What do you say about a person who hunted and killed an animal during his pilgrimage?" Imam al-Jawad said, "Did he go hunting while being in his ihram or not? Was he aware of that or not? Did he kill it intendedly or not? Was the muhrim a free person or a slave? Was he a child or an adult? Was the hunting from birds or other than birds? Was it young or grown up? Did the muhrim insist on his doing or he repented? Was it in the night or at day? Was the muhrim in the major hajj or the minor hajj?" The scholars stood up in astonishment and confused, and failure appeared on them. They could not imagine these branches on his questions. Loud calls of takbir filled the hall. It was clear to all that the Imams of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam were the source of knowledge and wisdom, and that Allah had gifted them. Later on in life, Imam al-Jawad agreed to marry Ma'mun's daughter, but she did not have any children, and therefore Ma'mun's plans for grandchildren who would succeed him failed. Imam Muhammad al-Jawad married other wives and had many children from them. Imam al-Jawad left Baghdad to Medina after his marriage. The Khalif Ma'mun fell sick and died not long after. After Ma'mun, the next unjust ruler was Mu'tasim. He openly disliked Imam al-Jawad because of his popularity, knowledge and piety, and did not want him living in Medina, so he forced the Imam to come back to Baghdad, where he could constantly spy on him and ensure he is not a threat. Mu'tasim was the half-brother of Ma'mun and a son of Harun al-Rashid, but his mother was Turkish. In due course, Mu'tasim brought many Turks to come and live in Baghdad. They became very powerful, and he built a new city for the Turkish soldiers further north, which today is called Samarra. Mu'tasim then decided to move his capital from Baghdad to Samarra. But before moving, he wanted to remove Imam al-Jawad permanently, as he was becoming more popular than him. Mu'tasim plotted and finally ordered the Imam to be poisoned. Of all the Imams, Imam Muhammad al-Jawad alayhi salam was martyred the youngest. He was only 25 years old. He was buried next to his grandfather Imam Musa al-Qadhim in Baghdad, in the area called Qadhimiyya today.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Allahumma.